Still ahead here on Fox 5, we have much more to come. Stay here. We'll be back.
Are you looking for more success at work? Well, who is it? Christy Whitman, author of Quantum Success, is here with the essential laws to jumpstart your prosperity. Did you hear that? It's a key word, prosperity. Well, welcome.
Thank you so much.
First of all, talk to me about quantum success. How does one achieve quantum success? What is it?
Well, quantum success is a combination of taking alignment, getting aligned with what you want, how you want to feel, what, you know, positive thoughts, the things that you say, being positive. So everything being in alignment with what you do want to create, and then taking action steps from there. It's not one or the other, it's both.
Okay, and this is, I feel like this, I've heard something similar. It's like your mind is very powerful.
Our minds are extremely powerful.
Yes.
We create our own reality, and things are created twice. First, when inside of ourselves, in our minds, and our, you know, inside of our own inner being, and then it's created on the outside.
Okay, so there are three steps that you're talking about specifically.
Yeah.
So can we start with the first step that someone needs to take if they want this quantum success?
Absolutely. So you want to create a big vision. You want to have a really big vision. So you might be at a career doing something that you don't love, you feel stuck. What do you feel called to do? What excites you? What would you just absolutely love to do? Create this big vision. What would you be doing? What would you be thinking, acting like, dressing like? Just create this whole big vision for yourself.
Oh, so what's the second step?
The second step is break it down into three goals. So we think, like you said, we are always projecting. It's like our minds are like a movie projector. So our minds need something to look at, fixate on, visualize. And so when you can create three different goals, you want to have something very specific. So for example, if you want to go to Paris, you want to have a picture of yourself in front of the Eiffel Tower.
Okay.
Or something that you can really look at and see that visual.
Okay, and so that, because then that gives you kind of like the steps then, right? Because like it's one thing to have this dream and a vision, but to actually have goals, it doesn't seem that far off.
Is exactly. Okay, exactly. Have a big vision and then three goals to get you there.
Okay.
And the third is then each and every day take some type of momentum along with alignment. You have to believe it's possible. You have to think that it's possible. You have to expect that type of success.
Yes.
You have to, all that has to be in alignment, and then take massive action.
Okay, how about this? If you want to make more money, right, how do we use the universal laws? How do we use that to help us?
Well, first thing is we have to clear our own relationship with money. Everybody has a relationship, whether you're aware of it or not, with money. And a lot of times our relationships are based on what we learn from our parents, our caregivers, society in general. So someone might think of the word money, and they might have a constriction because maybe mom had, you know, bad opinions of people that had money.
Sure.
Or maybe your parents argued a lot in their relationship, so your, you know, association with money is money's bad. Money causes
problems.
It's
a negative thing, yeah.
Yeah, so
okay.
We have to clear our own beliefs around money. Again, as within, so without. It's first created inside. If you have a good feeling relationship with money, you're going to be more attractive to money. If you're feeling bad inside, you repel money away.
Oh, we don't want to repel it away.
No, we all need it. You know, we all agreed in this society that we're all going to use this thing called money.
Right.
So we might as well have an easy going, fun relationship with it. Figure out why everybody wants money. I don't care if it's the, you know, billionaire or if it's someone that's in debt. We all want more money. What is that more money? And what do you think it's going to give you? Because we all think we want something because it's going to give us some sort of feeling. So it might be the feeling of success, power, security, fulfillment, whatever that is, and make that the dominant like feeling and vibration that you hold.
I like it. This was so good. I feel like this was so enlightening. See, you don't even realize the power of your mind. Thank you so much for being here. Christy
Absolutely.
Whitman again, author of Quantum Success. Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much for having
me. And more power to every one of you at home. All right.